Oh, hello. In this video, I'll show you how to add any domestic light to Home Assistant using just the Sonoff Basic, ESPHome and some screw terminal blocks. And I'll show you that you can keep your existing one or two-way wall switches working. And you won't be changing any wiring, making it easy to remove should you move home. But why use the Sonoff Basic? Well, they're simple enough to program and it's easy to add extra sensors. For example, by adding something like this in an automation, we can switch on a bathroom extractor fan. And of course, you'll still have the fan's pull cord to turn it off again. So let's get started. So the first thing we need to do is modify our Sonoff. Now we're coming off of 0 volts, which is these two here, and this pin here, which is the LED. So we're gonna snip off the LED, and also I'm gonna put some header pins on there for later. And here's one I did earlier. So LED's gone, header pins are on. And then I've taken two wires, 0 volts on that one, and this one's our GPIO 13. So next thing we need to do is get it programmed. The next thing we need to do is make the ESPHome code and get the Sonoff programmed. So we're gonna start a new one and we're gonna call this one bathroom underscore light. And we want the generic ESP8266, i.e. a Sonoff. Now here I'm using secrets in my code, so I'm gonna put that garbage here and continue and submit. So now we do a quick refresh and then in here, I'm gonna copy and paste the code. So in the code, we've got our name, which is bathroom light. It's the ESP8266 and it's the ESP01 1 meg. As I say, I'm using secrets for my Wi-Fi, so you'll need to change yours. So the rest of the code, we just need two items. One is the binary sensor. This will sense the state of the switch or switches, and that comes in, as you remember, on GPIO 13. We'll give it a name. This doesn't show up in HA, but it's just always good to name things. Internal true, so it doesn't show up. And then here, normally you'd have an on press. We use an on state, so that means it will sense the state change. So if it's on to off or off to on, then it's going to do a switch toggle, and the switch we're going to toggle is the relay. And that's down here under switch. The ID is relay. Don't change this. GPIO 12 is the internal pin for the relay itself on the board. This will show up in Home Assistant. So we'll give this a name and we'll call this one bathroom light. And then finally, if you want, you can add your own icon. I've just added a generic ceiling light here so it shows up. So with that, we're going to save. Next, we need to compile. And then once the compile's finished, we download the binary and then you'd use your flashing method to flash it to your Sonoff. So on the base, lining up with those two wires, I've snipped out a little bit of the tray. And then lining up with that tray, I've snipped out the hole for the wires as well. So get another connector block, put in about an inch or so, a couple of inches of wire on each one of those, ready to connect in, and then you're gonna need two longer pieces. So there we go, we've got our input with our connector block on, we've got our output with a few inches of wire on the end of it and our connector block coming out the bottom. So the next thing we need to do is connect it to our domestic light. In the UK, we have light switch, a lamp and a rose, and then we have the ring main. So I've got one coming in from the previous light, and this one goes out to the next light normally, and then they eventually go back to the fuse box. So this is a fully working setup, so I can switch it on and off. And then what I've also done is I've made this so it's a two-way light switch. So either one of these will turn the light on and off, and I can turn it on with one, turn it off with the other. So let's set our sun off. Now, word of warning, through these domestic light switches, the lamp, and obviously the ring main, there is 220 to 240 volts. If you're not happy, or if you're not qualified, please don't attempt this. Get a qualified electrician to do this part for you. Other than that, enjoy the rest of the video. First of all, we want to make sure that our power is off. Just make sure in the fuse box that the power is off where you're working, especially on the part, in this case the light, that you're working on. So we want to unscrew the rose. Now inside here, you'll see two neutrals coming in and one going out to the light. you'll see two lives coming in and one going out to light, and a third one. The third one comes from your switch. Also from your switch is what's called the switch live. You should see this is marked somehow with a little bit of red tape or a little bit of red sleeving. This one is connected to your light. So you've got a three, and a two. So your three neutrals are all common. The three brown wires are all common in the three block there. And then you've got your switched live and your lamp coming out. What we want to do is we want to take all these wires out, just leave the two light bulb ones. Right, once all the wires are disconnected, you can pull them all out the back. So let's add our sun off. I've taken the ring in and the ring out, and I've connected both the wires into our connector block there, which is the live in. And then the switch has come out of the rows and has gone to the two wires that we've added into the side. And then these two wires will simply come back through here and connect to the neutral of your bulb and the live. In the ceiling, you'll have your ring in and your ring out connected to the two blocks there. And see that coming out, look, earth's there. And then your switch is connected to that little block that we put on the side, and then the two wires from the output come back through the ceiling, through the back of the rows, and then these go across the neutral and the live, which both go down to the bulb. So I pop the whole thing back up into the ceiling, nice and secure. You can turn the power back on. I've still got my functionality. We got their three-way switch still working. This one I've called bathroom light. I've added it into my Lovelace. We can turn the light on and off here, and then I can turn it on from here and then turn it off with either one of the switches. I'll turn it back on again, turn it off from the other switch, turn it on from one of these. You can see the entity light up there. So now we're all ready for our automations and everything else. Well, I hope this video was helpful with your projects. Please do share it so others can find it as well. I upload videos whenever I can, so subscribe and hit the bell icon to get notified. That's it. Thanks for watching.